Again, hello, Nastya.
Hello.
Hello, Hani. Hani's with us today. There you go. There
Yes.
he is. Hello, everybody. Welcome once again with a live stream. Today, Nastya and I, we're gonna kick off the week with
Music lesson,
yeah, exactly,
you can
music
say.
lesson, musicality, a little bit of yeah, music lesson. Honestly, musicality, it's always been the subject that I always been really interested, but also had a lot of difficulties. Even though I started music, I went to music school. Took me some time to corporalize my listening, and also it took me a while to find the right way to explain to bring that information to you. So we're gonna do the best we can. I think it's really we have kind of developed a method that is really useful. And of course, it's going to be really hard for us to give you feedback because we can't see you. Hopefully, you're there.
But soon we will.
Soon we will. Soon we
And
will.
then we will work it out more.
So feel free to anytime pause the video and rewind and look back because we're going to give different pieces of information that we're pretty sure is going to be really useful. And always, the music is it's gonna define you as an interpreter, right? So we really think it's a really, I mean, we really believe in the music and the musicality in the dance. Well, it's a really
Yeah.
important and rich resource.
It gives quality, and I think it's we talked a lot, it's a meeting point between the two. So it's very, very important. We'll try to give you the time you need to listen to the music or the song we brought today, so you understand the concepts, and also bring it to your body and to your dance. That's also important. From the ear to the body, yeah?
Yeah, totally. Nastya was super accurate with what she said. And something really important, it's that this is equally important for leaders and followers. Musicality, it's a matter that it's important for both of us. Yeah, because I've been asked a few times, like, isn't it the leader the responsible of the musicality? No, not necessarily. Followers, you also have a big role when it comes to interpreting the music. And as Nastya said, it's a common point. So if my leader is not paying attention, then as a follower, we're gonna struggle. And the same the other way around. If the leader is listening to the music, but the follower is a little bit lost, then we're gonna find kind of the same conflicts. Yeah? Let's kick it off with the first thing. First things first, most important that we think and that we believe is gonna help you in tango, it's find the pulse, find the beat of the music, right? The pulse, it's like our pulse. It's the heart of the music. It's what keeps us track of what's the speed of the pumping heart, right? And of course, it's what we follow when we dance.
And maybe it's the easiest to also feel it, I
Yeah.
think, the beat. It's always there in every song.
So we're gonna play the song that we're gonna work with today. And we're gonna just hear it a little bit, and we're gonna mark the pulse for you, mark what's the beat for us, right? That hopefully is gonna be the same for you. So we go with the music. First, we're gonna nod. Yeah, maybe we can. Really good. Let's do some weight change here, yeah? So every time we feel the beat, we change weights. Pretty good. I hope that you're following it from home. I know this doesn't look super exciting, but we're really paying attention to the music and trying to find the beat exactly where it falls, yeah? Really good. And now what we're gonna do, we're just gonna continue with the song like that. And we're gonna dance one song entire, or whatever we have left from the song. on the beat. That means that we're gonna do all the steps and all the things we know how to do on the beat, yeah? We're gonna show it a little bit. Out of frame, sorry, it's my fault. Good. So, what we did right there is just we were marking the balls, then we changed weight. And then we just dance the whole thing on the beat. Yeah, we never accelerated. The only thing we wanted to do, it was to follow that beat over again, to repeat it, to make sure that we really feel comfortable with that beat. Be careful, because sometimes we have certain steps directly connected to rhythm. So sometimes when we ask you to dance the whole dance on the beat, it means the whole dance. For example, our tendency is when we do the cross, to do the cross quick, slow, to go bam, bam, and my follower, bam, bam, bam. Again, we're gonna try to show it without going out of frame. Sorry, there we go, it's my fault. Bam, 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 bam. So there's a quick, slow there, yeah? And the exercise before, we were trying to push you to make sure that you were doing it on the beat, which sometimes is gonna, yeah, it's gonna be slower of what we get used to, yeah?
This means that you really need to try to take the steps long, as long as you can. And yeah, I think that's very important in order to manage this beat. And also in the cross, it's very important, that aspect, I feel, for myself.
The cross, but sometimes it's our fault as teachers. Sometimes we put so much emphasis, if we emphasize the cross, always putting a quick, slow. But today, I will ask you to practice it on the beat, yeah? So just pick a song and try to follow and dance one entire song following the beat, yeah?
Slow down if you are used to do it faster. Some parts of it.
Normally, in a normal lesson, we would just play a song and we will watch you. But since we don't have that possibility, we're going to assume that you're practicing home and that you're dancing your song on the beat, right? You're not cheating us, right? Right?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Good. So what we have prepared for you, it's like we're going to bring it in the frame. Do, 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 do. So numbers. Let me find
the
right.
Lesson.
Yes. This is the part of the music lesson. So we have brought, sorry, I don't get the angle with the camera.
I know,
there
I
we
like
go.
To have a musician, Herman, here.
So we can use the mathematics of the music in order to understand what the hell goes on when we listen music, yeah? Music, it's really symmetrical in the way it's composed. And the way we perceive the music is also really symmetric. Asymmetrical music, we don't perceive it like music. Yeah, unless we're, I don't know, professional musicians, contemporary music, blah, 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 right? Sometimes it's really fine, it's hard to find the musicality in the music if we don't respect certain numbers. Tango, fortunately, as all the many other musics, it has a pattern that we can define. We can just put numbers and use it as a guide, yeah? So going back to this idea of filling the beats, yeah, what we're gonna do is we're gonna organize all those beats, yeah, and we're gonna put a number until 8. But we'll explain you why until 8. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna play again the same song we were hearing before, and we're gonna count with you and show you where we put the 1 and where we put the 8. So we could play the same song again. 1 second. Really good. Thank you, honey. And for us, it goes here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That was it, yeah? Sorry, I'm gonna go back and forth to the music. So it's not random where the 1 starts and where we put the 1 and where we put the 8. It's connected to something that we're listening. And it's something that we call it phrase. Yeah? The phrase is it's like a question and an answer together. It's like, you know, in a dialogue, like a real phrase and a verbal phrase. And we're gonna pay attention. I'm not gonna be counting, I'm just gonna be marking here, but you're not gonna hear my voice. But what you're gonna hear is like in the first 4, there is a kind of a question, and in the other 4s, there is an answer. Yeah. Sometimes in this song in particular is like that. Sometimes you're gonna have a question of 8 beats and an answer of 8 beats. Doesn't matter. We're always gonna have 8 beats in tango. So we hear it again. So question. Answer. Question again. And last one. Exactly. So what we're gonna ask you, always we're using the beat. I don't know if you can see, we're gonna bring it a little bit closer. I hope I don't break everything. You see that there is small orange points, red points on top of each number.
You can see.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you can see. So what we're gonna ask you to do in this next exercise, it's to avoid this beat, to avoid the last one. Can I remove it?
Can I?
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, so now you can see that we have a point in each beat except the 8. So what we try to do, it's a pause on the 8th beat. It was correct. What we're asking you, it's a pause on the 8th beat. That means that we're not going to step either changed weight on the 8th beat. Yeah? We're going to show it to you. I'm going to dance it for you. But then you will have to practice it at home too. Okay? So here we go again.
Promise.
Thank you. Do-do-do-do-do-do. We take out this one. Do-do-do-do-do. The dancer comes in. Sorry, I'm going to remove this. Musica, maestro. A little bit lower, sorry. We need to. 1 second. From the beginning, there we go. 2, 3. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Really good. Gracias, Ignacia. So what we're doing there, it's like really dancing the phrase. We're starting in one, and we're taking a small pause on the eighth beat because we want to emphasize again the beginning of the phrase. Yeah, the beginning of the big phrase. It's a little bit tricky, so I know it looks silly, but try it home, and you will see that once that we're on the beat, sometimes it's really hard to hold that beat that we don't want to step in.
You have to really be in yourself and not to support yourself on the other in that. To help you actually slow down and not to step, actually. So it's a very good exercise, not only music, not only to communicate and know where each of us is, but it's also the quality of your own dance. So it's great, practice it. Yeah?
We're going to show it one more time with no music this time, because what we want to make sure is that you're stepping on each beat, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and during the 8, you only have to collect and then continue and get ready for the first one again. Be careful with this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah.
1. Yeah, I don't know if you saw the difference. The second time I did it, I changed weight on the 8th beat. We changed weight on the 8th beat. It's not what we're asking. We want you to collect 7, 8, and then start on 1. We don't want you to 7, 8, change weight, and then continue.
Because so you continue on the same leg.
Exactly, because changing weight, it's considered as a step. Yeah? We show it one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Also, Vida. So, yeah.
Yeah, yeah? And try, of course, to take the time to collect the leg. Yeah. So we are 7, and then we take the time to collect. It's not 7, 8, and I wait here. Try to really enjoy this moment of collecting.
And find a little bit of continuity too, right? I think that Nazia was kind of doing really clear that she's 7, 8, 1, and not 7, 8, 1.
Yeah, like, yeah? Breaking it to boom. It's we need the flow.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what we practice.
Of course, we're going really fast here because it's only the two of us. And we don't have any feedback from you. Take your time. Feel free always to pause it, yeah, and make sure that you find continuity, that we're not stepping or changing weight on the 8th beat, that we really take a pause there. And then we're automatically we'll dancing with the logic of the music. We will use this mathematical part of music and use it in our benefit, our own benefit.
And these later on advancing levels, it will really make a difference to your dance, really a lot. In figures and elements we haven't tried yet, but they will come, and they are very, like, we meet them in tango so often, and knowing the beat, both of us at the same time, it's so, so important.
Really good. We move on. Yes? We're gonna ask you something quite similar. We're going to bring this one again. Hello. This way? No, that way. I don't get it. Yeah, and what we're going to ask you now is also to take a pause on the 4th beat. And I mean, on the 4th and the 8th, because we know the pause from before. So we're going to add one more pause, yeah? So here, basically, what we're going to do, we're gonna listen it first, and I'm going to be here, like, pointing, and then we're going to dance. We're going to show it to you, yeah? So with the music, you will see that the moment of the 4 would be like the pause of the question, and here would be the pause of the answer. Yeah? Musica, maestro. Pause, 5, 6, 7, pause. 1, 2, 3, pause, 5, 6, 7. Pause. If we're listening to music, it will make sense. So, thank you, Annie. So, it is connected not only with the mathematics. I mean, the numbers will help us, but it's a matter of intuition too.
Yeah, so you will. It's a moment to breathe, actually.
It's
either while talking the phrase or dancing it. It's a moment to. I take the next step. Yeah.
Exactly. I couldn't have had explained it better. It's a moment of a pause. It's a moment of air. Yeah. So we're gonna dance it. Boom. Musica maestro.
Dancing.
Feels
natural. Good.
I mean, it feels it makes sense. Yeah, and we just use the numbers. It's not that okay. We know the song, but we can apply this to all songs in tango. Mostly all songs in tango, and never find, and you will find a feeling that it makes total sense. Yeah, so use this because it's really useful. It really. What we study it, right? As we said before, and we really spend a lot of time talking about it, and it gives. You will see that the moment you breathe, the moment you take a pause, you will feel that the melody, also the phrase, is taking a pause. Yeah, the phrase is really connected to the melody too. We're trying not to speak too much about melody because, yeah, well, I don't know why, but the phrase is something to do with melody, right? A phrase could have two melodies. One. An asking melody and an answering melody, and you will see that music it's like that. Otherwise, we don't even consider it as music. Our brain doesn't conceive it as music. So it's something that it's really it's the root. It's something totally inherent. It's connected to the music. It's part of the music, and we want to bring it to tango, in order to make sure that we also respect those same. Things that the music has.
Because I mean, we dance the music, right? It's not about just doing steps and learning figures and learning ochos and cross and, but it's more like how we bring that into the music, how the music dresses our dance. So have that in mind because the beautiful dancers you admire out there, they really play with that a lot, and they make it delicious and beautiful. So
yeah, that was also it's like when the dancers are dancing the music is when we go like how the hell did they do that?
It's the spice, right? It's the spice in the dance.
It really good. And what we're gonna do a really last exercise that we have prepared for you today. We're gonna bring back boom 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 the numbers. So what you were doing in order to take a pause in the fourth and the eighth, what we were doing is that we were making this only one step. You can see that, right? And also this one. We're making it only in one step. Then that means that when we take a pause, what we were doing is like we're using two beats for one step, right? Again, we were using two beats only for one step. So in order to give you something more that you can practice home and the key of the what you were doing, it's we're gonna imagine that each step we're gonna take is gonna last two beats. Yeah. So we're gonna take only 4 steps in the entire phrase, right? This big circle red is because we're asking you to, no, we keep this one and we remove this one. There we go.
And the others here.
Yeah, exactly. So what we're going to ask you, if I can remove this one, I'm fighting now. There we go. You can see it better. So now what we're going to ask you is like you step on one, but it has to last until 3. So it means that we're going to step 1, 3, 5, 7. So
it's
we're going to...
said before with the flow, yes?
Yeah. So we have there the caption that says, walk every second beat. And that's exactly what we're going to do. That's exactly what you were doing in the beginning of the lesson, but you were doing it only here. Then you also did it here because you were taking this pause. So now we're going to ask you to do it in the whole phrase. That will really push, level up your technique because you will, honestly, what you will do, it's like you're going to focus technically in what you and what we ask you in the beginning, but full control of it. So we're going to show it, yeah? We're in. Musica maestro. Five, six, seven, eight, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sorry, I'm out of frame. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. One more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes. So that was that is all. You will see that that's it's not that easy. It will take, first of all, common understanding between the two of us that we really want to change with rhythm and that we're capable of doing that.
And you slow down and you wait.
Yeah. And you try to take it for the whole phrase. That definitely will it's a good challenge for Begunde Falsetta and Tango 1. And then you can combine it as you want. When you're dancing, you can, if you want to dance every beat, you dance every beat. If you want to walk every second beat, you step every second beat. If you want to do a combination, if you find your new combinations, we will be really glad and happy to see it, right?
Sometimes the music actually asks for the beat, dancing on the beat, or every second beat.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You will sometimes, I think that if you're able to work it beforehand, then when you're dancing, when in the social environment, you're just gonna follow your intuition. You're not gonna be counting all the time, but the training of it will help you to respond in the way you want to respond. Yeah. So I think that was it for today.
Thank you very much.
We did what we could. I think it was hopefully for you. Hopefully it was good and helpful for you, and I hope that you were following and watching it from home.
And. Tomorrow and the rest of the week, you will continue and get more material on musicality.
Yes, it's the musicality week. I hope that you enjoy it, and thank you very much for being there.
And see you.
Bye-bye.